In this lesson, we will describe how you can use ToposPro to perform a comprehensive topological analysis of MOFs. We will show how to do the analysis, how to simplify the structure, how to make different structure representations, and how to classify the corresponding nets. Let's look at the example of the MOF 5. We start from importing the data from a CIF file. ToposPro creates a new database. Let's open the crystal data window. This is standard crystallochemical information, space groups, unit cell parameters, atomic coordinates, but there is no information about atom connectivity. We just have the position of atoms in the space, and so we need to restore the connectivity. For this purpose, ToposPro uses special algorithms, which are based on the Voronoi partition of the crystal space. The algorithms are realized in the AutoCM program. We can use default options for most types of the structures. You can find more information about the AutoCM program in our video lesson, the AutoCM program. Now we have a special tab adjacency metrics where we have complete information about the atom's connectivity. We can look at this structure with the isochrist program. This is the complete framework, roughly speaking the complete structure, because we do not consider the interstitial molecules. Now we need to simplify the structure. This is the general route for topological analysis in ToposPro. In this route, we will find structural groups, simplify the net by squeezing these groups to their centers of mass, and finally identify the topology of the structure and classify it and probably find the topological analogs of the structure. We should choose metal atoms and organic ligands as structural units and replace them with their centers of mass. This is the so-called standard representation in ToposPro. So, to construct the underlying net, we run ADS, Options, and here we should select the Save Simplified Net option, Standard Method. I also check the option Keep Initial Structure to merge the initial and simplified structures together. Now we should select Central Atoms. The central atoms will not be changed during simplification. Other atoms are considered as parts of the ligands and will be squeezed to the centers of mass of the ligands. In the case of metal complexes, we should select the metal atoms as central. In this case, the metal atoms will keep their positions and ions or ligands will be squeezed to their centers of mass, so I select zinc atoms. Now I have a database with a simplified structure. There are three different types of simplified centers: zinc atoms, oxygen atoms, and centers of organic linkers. Let's look at the structure. As you can see, the Za pseudo atom coincides with the center of mass of the benzene decarboxylate, Zb and Zc with oxygen and zinc atoms respectively. I make the simplification again to obtain their underlying net only, so I uncheck the Keep Initial Structure option. Now I have simplified centers only, and I can determine the topology of the underlying net. For this purpose, I use the ADS Options default button. This button sets the options for classification of the underlying net of the crystal structure. I should select central atoms again. In this case, central atoms are taken into account during classification. other atoms are not considered. We should consider all nodes. As you can see, the net has the FFF topological type. Let's look at the structure. We can also find the structures with the same topology using our TopCrist service. You should enter the name of topological type and look at the examples. We consider here the structure as a set of metal atoms, which are the coordination centers and molecular linkers, which connect these centers together. But we can analyze the same structure in another way. We can select polynuclear complex groups, these tetrahedral groups, as structural units, and linkers between them as other units. This is the so-called cluster representation in ToposPro. To do the cluster simplification, I select the compound, run ADS, options tab common, check the option Save Simplified Net, and choose the cluster simplification method. Now I should select the central atoms. I select here all atoms because I do not know what structural groups are here. I just ask ToposPro to find the structural groups for this network. ToposPro creates possible representations of the structure as the sets of structural groups. We have a new database with the same name, but with the suffix C. Let's look at the structure. You see, ToposPro has split the structure into four nuclear groups and linkers between them. How did ToposPro recognize the structural units? This is completely topological approach. ToposPro analyzes all rings in the framework, from small rings to the large ones. Then ToposPro classifies all bonds into intracluster and intercluster. The intracluster bonds belong to the small rings, in this case to the six-membered rings, and their intercluster bonds belong to very long rings. All intercluster valence bonds were changed to pseudohydrogen bonds. Using this approach, we can split the structure into separate units, squeeze them to their centers of mass, and finally obtain their underlying topology. This comment means that all bonds which belong to the rings of size 6 and less are intracluster, while the bonds belonging to the rings of size 7 and more are intercluster. Now we should perform the standard simplification for the molecular structure, where the structural units are connected by the pseudohydrogen bonds. If you do not know how to do it in detail, see our lesson, the standard simplification method. So I run the ADS options, Save Simplified Net, Standard Method. Tab Topology specifies that valence bonds connect atoms and hydrogen bonds connect molecular structural units. Then I press Run. In the window Central Atoms, press Whole Molecule. We have simplified the structure. There are two coordinated nodes here, so before classification, I have to transform them into the net edges. I open Compound, Auto-Determine, Simplified Adjacency Matrix, remove all 0, 1, and 2 coordinated nodes. Now I can classify the structure. I click ADS, Options, Topology, Default. Here we have a PCU network. This is another representation of the same structure. The question is, what is the best representation of the structure? Strictly speaking, there is no best representation. It depends on the task. If you analyze the structure from the point of view of how metal atoms are connected together, you can use the standard representation. If you are interested in connectivity of the polynuclear complex groups, you should use the cluster representation. Anyway, using different representations of the same structure, you can find many relations of this structure to other structures. You can perform all described operations in an automatic way for thousands of structures in the same session. You can find how to do it in our video lessons, standard simplification methods, and special methods of simplifications. ToposPro also enables you to find interpenetrations in the MOF structure. To do it, you should simplify the structure and classify the underlying net. If the net has any interpenetration, you will find the corresponding information in the output data. In the section Structure Group Analysis, you can see the composition of the framework, the number of the interpenetrating nets, the interpenetration parameters, and the class of interpenetration. You can find more information about interpenetration in our video lesson Entanglements. You can construct the tiling for MOFs to analyze the pores in the structure. For this purpose, you should construct the underlying net and delete 0, 1, and 2 coordinated nodes. Now you can construct the tiling with the ADS program. I run ADS, Options, Topology. I have to set the All Rings option, then set maximum ring equal to 12, that is enough for most structures. If you set too small maximum ring and no proper tiling can be constructed, then you should increase the maximum ring size. Then I switch to the tiling tab. I have to specify the maximal number of the tile faces. The maximum tile size, 200, is sufficient for most nets. I should check the natural tiles option. As you can see, the options locally strong rings and single tiling turn on automatically. These three options ensure that the tiling obeys the natural tiling rules. I run ADS. It suggests to select central atoms. These are the atoms to be taken into account during the tile construction. I select all Z atoms. This is the information about all tiles and their properties. This table summarizes the main information about the tiling. You can find more information about tilings in our video lesson Constructions of Tiling. So you can use ToposPro to perform a really comprehensive topological analysis of a particular MOF. This analysis is universal and enables you to find relations of this MOF to other structures with similar topology.